made you some content. Daddy made you your favorite open wide. Here comes the content. It's a beautiful day to stay inside.
Greetings, mood killers. It's Eddie and Marconi with you, and it's the end of an era, and I can't believe it is finally over. It ended a few weeks back, but I just got around to finishing the series.
I'm still here. I'm not dead.
Oh, excuse me.
You're talking about a show.
Excuse me. I got a nasty person over there. I was talking about Curb Your Enthusiasm. Curb.
Yeah, I was asking you to finish the show so we could talk about it.
Excuse me.
3 weeks ago, like when it was over. Yeah, now
well,
it's finally over. You finally done it. So you liked it?
Well, the way that streaming works, too, is like I figured a little bit of a delay for us to talk about it on the air. It gives people a little bit of a common courtesy, too.
I don't
care
anymore.
Finish up this year.
Watch the damn show, people. That's what I'm saying.
It's over. After 12 seasons, Curb Your Enthusiasm is over. Larry David has packed it up. It's over.
Now.
And,
Did you do like me when you watched the final episode? Did you go back and immediately watch the first episode and notice that he did a joke in there about his pants was the first joke on the first episode? It's the same thing they did on Seinfeld with the button.
Exactly. And I caught that because I remembered that first Curb episode with the pants thing.
Yeah.
And
the pants tent.
And then I knew what he was doing because that's how the end of Seinfeld worked, as it kind of was a loop. Of the first conversation that they had in the first episode. And then, then Jerry breaks the cycle.
That was so good.
And basically, you know, okay, we can talk. Let's just talk freely here.
Yeah, if you don't want to know what it is, then don't listen and pause this or forward it or whatever.
Or fast
if you're
forward
listening
to the next segment.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Whatever, however you're listening.
Yeah.
So the final episode of Curb Your Enthusiasm is basically like a redo of the final episode of Seinfeld.
They wanted to get it right because he's always told that last episode. You knew it was coming when J.B. Smooth's character, Leon, starts referring to, I've been watching all the Seinfeld episodes. I'm about to watch the last episode, Larry. And then, you know, then he says, well, you kind of messed that up, you know?
Yeah, and that's the criticism. That's one of Larry David's biggest criticisms he's had in his career is that he screwed up the final episode of Seinfeld. So, you could tell that his mission was to correct that or at least prove that he could be creative in other ways, too, if he chooses to. And I thought it was brilliant because...
he brings in Jerry Seinfeld, Seinfeld... is in some coffee shop or someplace getting a drink, and he runs into a guy, and the guy's kind of an a-hole and was like weird. I can't remember what he said or what he did, but then it turns out this guy was on the jury for Larry David's trial in Georgia, and Larry David was supposed to spend a couple of years in prison, kind of like on Seinfeld, and he's sitting there talking about his pants tent. And in comes Jerry and bails him out because they found they had a mistrial because of this juror.
Yeah, the juror was out in the real world when he was supposed to be sequestered. And and Jerry was able to prove that. So that made a mistrial. And then they busted Larry out. Then as they were walking out of the jail, they're like, this is how we should have ended Seinfeld. Nobody wanted to see the characters in prison. And I thought it was good. And it was an acknowledgement of that. And that was the best way, instead of, you know, trying to do another season of Seinfeld or redo the finale somehow today, which would be horrible, which everybody says that they should do. No. This was a tribute and a nod to all the big Seinfeld fans out there. So if you're any sort of Seinfeld fan, you would
Wasn't
like Curb.
Wasn't it great when they brought, they were bringing, on Curb, they were bringing back all the characters from the show's past of Curb. And you're just seeing all these people like, oh, yeah, there's a, remember the Spite Store? You know, that was only a couple of seasons ago. And different ones that you were like, oh, my gosh, this is so great. It's just like they're doing everything. And I knew as soon as he was on trial in that Georgia, and he was also trying to make a statement about how dumb that issue is, the reason he was on trial, if you didn't watch it, was because he handed a woman a bottle of water who was waiting to vote in Georgia. Apparently that's against the law there now. So
it is, yeah.
It was a great, great episode. I mean, the whole season was great. And I'm in the process of rewatching the entire series again. So there you go.
Yeah. So thank you, LD, for the years and years of entertainment, officially for Mood Killers. We love it. Mood
Killers. Why don't you just keep your big mouth shut?
Let's bring back the tech tickle. This is our tech news segment. Yes. We'll see what's happening in the world of tech.
Smartphones, artificial intelligent girlfriends, and drones. It's the tech tickle on Mood Killers.
All right.
What's that? It was an Irish jig band, and then like, what's going on there? Oh man,
yeah, I don't know, but that's now the theme, and I don't know. It doesn't make any sense. But
it's not
there
nothing
it
you can do about it.
Yeah, that's it. You know, you commission an artist to make something for you, and you run out of time and budget, and you're stuck.
So. Yeah.
Space junk crashed into a Florida home. I guess a chunk of metal fell through the roof, and it was something that came off of the International Space Station. Then it just, this thing was a pallet or something. It had 5,000 pounds of aging batteries on it.
Well,
and it's
sort of like my junk
drawer.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. It's the junk drawer of the International Space Station.
It just crashed into somebody's house. Nobody was hurt. Yeah. Like, nobody was injured or anything like that.
As far as we know, they might be, dust underneath the 5,000 pound battery.
I mean, those batteries might be leaking into their water system now, and they don't even know. They're drinking space battery liquids. We don't want that.
Yeah. So when that happens, do you sue space?
I think so. I think so. You got the.
Is that who you sue?
Yeah. Who do you call for that? It's got to be one of those TV lawyers. Call 577-254. You know, whatever it is.
Has space junk fallen on your home? Call today.
Yes. You only pay if I get you money.
Right. speaking of junk. Tesla has halted the Cybertruck.
Are you kidding? I've seen so many TikToks of horrible things, and I think I know what you're going to mention here, but I'll let you, because I don't want to take it over, but it looks like such a piece of garbage, the Cybertruck.
Well, yeah, I mean, there's been a lot of issues, and what you've seen may be a completely separate issue, because I've seen at least a half a dozen. It's being halted now because of accelerator pedal issues.
Yep.
I guess there's an issue.
Yeah. Yeah,
they're saying it's falling off or something, or
yeah, the accelerator, you know, they have
two things you don't want.
It looks like some kind of fancy thing. This covering for the accelerator pedal that's on top of it, the metal part, it comes loose and slides up and wedges into the front part of the car, but pushes the pedal down. So it's stuck in full, like, if you put the pedal to the metal, literally, it's stuck. And the only thing, if you don't know, that if you push the pedal of the gas, the brake down, that it does disengage the pedal. But if you don't know that, like, you might be driving into a wall or something.
That's one thing that you don't want your accelerator pedal to do, is to get stuck or fall off. I mean, that's a basic thing. How can you release a car where that happens? Elon?
There's another one where, like, it hailed, and they have this massive windshield that's flat because they want it to look a certain way. And just a normal, like, medium-sized hail cracked the windshield of this one Cybertruck. And it costs, like, nearly $4,000 to replace that thing. And it's supposed to be able to, like, withstand a baseball hitting it, all this stuff they claim. And, you know, people are, and there's all kinds of stuff. Like, there's, like, a cover that you can get for, I don't know what it's, camping or an extension. It's like a tent. And it's the tent costs $3,000. It looks like a sack of garbage on the back of your truck.
Right.
Just like, I don't understand what they're doing. They're laying a bunch of people off at Tesla. It just doesn't, it doesn't seem like things are going well.
No. Yeah. And those employees that they're firing at Tesla, I think 10% of the workforce, and instead of giving them pink slips, they're putting them in self-driving cars, Teslas, and then just letting it take care of itself.
Oh, God, no.
Let's see what's going on in the world of technology with our tech tickle.
Smartphones, artificial intelligent girlfriends, and drones. It's the tech tickle on Mood Killers.
Is that a Git fiddle? Yeah. I think it might be a Git fiddle in there.
Yeah. Yeah, I think so.
I mean, that's a departure from that other one you did where the guy was...
Bugs and stuff and tanks.
Like, you know, this is a whole different ballgame. Yeah.
Right. I think it's the same band. They just switched singers.
I see.
Yeah. Elon Musk is going to start charging a temporary fee for people who sign up to Twitter. I'm calling it Twitter.
Don't you tired of people like going X, formerly Twitter? Like, you know what? It's his job to promote it or get it right. It's not ours. Like, you know, when a stadium renames, it's like some, you know, like whatever brand it is, they're not paying me a dime to say that name. I'll say whatever it is. No. Like, you know, like the Moda Center.
Calling it whatever I want.
If I want to call it the Rose Garden, I will. You know what I mean? Eddie?
Or like the Sears Tower. Everybody calls it the Sears Tower in Chicago, but it's not the Sears Tower anymore.
Right. It's not owned by Sears anymore. And but nobody calls it, local people don't call it the Willis Tower. No, go to hell.
Right.
So
to hell, Elon.
But so now Elon on a failing platform that everyone is leaving, and it's not even on Twitter for like, I don't know, 20 years. Was on the top two or three of the apps in the App Store, has fallen off. It's not even top 50 anymore. So people are like, you know, like I haven't deleted my account completely because I know eventually somebody's going to go, you know what, let's just buy it and fix it back to Twitter. Elon doesn't, you know, I don't know. I have hope because I still liked Twitter the way it was before. And
I'm pretty sure at some point, somebody's going to come along. It's going to be like The Rock or Kid Rock.
The Rock or Kid Rock. Oh, that's better? God. No, but yeah, like, so now he wants people to pay just to have Twitter, you have to pay? Like, before it was like you paid $11 and you could get verified because everyone wanted to be verified that didn't deserve it or need to be. And now if you pay $11, so what? $19, almost $20 now you'll have to be on Twitter?
Well, I guess what they're going to do is they're going to charge, a $1 annual fee to access basic features such as creating posts and interacting with others.
No, thanks.
Yeah. $1 annual. I'm not giving him a cent.
No.
No.
It's $1 too many.
Go to hell.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, and who wants to be on there? The only thing he did... what he wanted to do for the election year was ruin Twitter because it was there was a lot of people that didn't believe the way he does politically, and he doesn't agree with them. So he went on there and said, you know what? I'm going to ruin it so they'll all go away. And you know what? Congratulations. You have ruined Twitter. And nobody wants to be on there. And the only people you go on there and there's people and like if I even look on it, if I have any kind of account at all, it's always like. Dudes in sunglasses with their hat, you know, like you know what I'm talking about, Eddie. Their profile picture, they've got the Oakleys and the dad hat, and they're always real angry about stuff. And it's like Twitter used to be fun. Now it's like a cesspool.
Yeah, yeah. Well, anytime we bring up Elon Musk, we know that it's going to turn into just a rant about how terrible he is, and I'm here for it. And I. Yeah. I'll pop popcorn for this any day. There's your tech tickle.
It's the tech tickle on Mood Killers.
Yeah! Eddie, whether you like it or not, it's time to learn something. Did you know? Did you know every baseball that's used in major league and minor leagues is rubbed with a special mud from New Jersey before it's shipped or used in a game?
Why?
Okay.
Mud. Sure, it's mud. Whatever. Yeah, I don't know. That's weird. I guess they want to rough it up so it's not too slick, but seems like you could just sand it down a little bit. You have to rub it in mud? Okay. Here's another one. Did you know 2/3 of the world's polar bears live in Canada? That's
okay.
Polar bears. Yeah, I love them to see videos of them, but I would never want to be in real life face to face with a polar bear that's not like at a, you know, a zoo or something like that.
I barely want to do that.
Yeah.
I feel bad for the polar bear.
Oh, yeah.
Especially when you go to the zoo in the middle of the summer and you see the polar bear. I don't like that because then they put out like a couple of snow cones for it. So it feels like it's at home and it's just never.
Right.
I don't know. I don't like the zoo. It makes me sad.
I don't like the zoo either, I'll be honest. Yeah, but it's like one of those things like, well, it's one chance for me to see these animals. And, you know, but I see enough of them online. It's about the same. You know, you see all these places. I like when a polar bear jumps in the water in front of a crowd and gets, people screaming, it seems like they enjoy that, but I don't like them being entrapped in a cage. But that's just me.
No, but, I agree.
Did you know Long Johns are named after a boxer in Boston from the 1870s named John Sullivan? I guess he would wear them in the ring. They are very comfortable when you wear them to bed in the winter. But But, you know, I always see those when people actually wear them, like back in the day, you always see those gritty old sweaty guys that have been, hoeing dirt all day. And underneath their clothing, they've got these long johns and they just slip off their clothes and slip right into a greasy bed. And that seems so disgusting.
And the bed always is like yellow from their sweat.
Yeah.
Their pajamas are yellow and I don't know. I'm glad that our hygiene has improved so much over the years. I wouldn't have survived in that era.
No, me either. Here's another one, Eddie.
Like you don't have Purell. Ew.
Did you know that the sriracha has a rooster on the bottle? Because the guy who created it was born in 1945, which was the year of the rooster. So,
oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, and I don't know about you. I get the, because you can't really find the sriracha, like the regular stuff that we're used to getting in stores
as
much anymore.
They changed the recipe, right? Well, even the regular branded one, the real stuff, I don't know if this is true or not, but I read somewhere that the deal that they had with the farm where they got their sriracha peppers expired or they had a disagreement or something.
Yeah.
So now they're getting it from somewhere else and it just doesn't taste the same.
It's just dumb. The whole thing is dumb. Like it was like some weird thing, like the pricing. It was like if he paid $2 more per bushel or something like that, they could have kept their deal. And they didn't want to do it. Yeah. It was something really dumb. And but I will say,
well, you know, they would have passed that along to us as the consumer. You know, they probably still raise the price.
Oh yeah, I think I get one of those giant like 32-ounce bottles. I get two of them for like $30 or something. So they definitely have passed it along. Eddie, did you know when Samsung started in 1938? It was a trading company that sold dried fish, groceries, and noodles. And it didn't start getting into electronics until the late 1960s.
Now, was that a real guy, Sam Sung?
Yeah. Johnny Samsung, I believe his name.
Yeah.
I don't know where the name came from. It doesn't say that here, but I can't imagine getting a Samsung dried fish noodle. It doesn't seem right. You know,
I always think it's cool when companies start out as one thing and then they
pivot,
completely change it. Yeah. They pivot to something so different. It's really interesting how that
it
can
is a weird thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
And I like, by the way, I think Samsung has some of the best electronics. I mean, they are one of the best makers of electronic, like TVs, stuff like that. I mean, and I don't know. I don't get like the phones, but didn't before the iPhone, they had a pretty good game going, didn't they? Or was it, or did they just start?
No, I think they did. Yeah. They still do. I think so. And Nokia, I guess they started out as a paper company or something. That's what I remember.
Yeah. And then they made paper
phones. And
then
Wrigley, of course, you know, the
gum.
The gum. Yeah. That was started out as what? Soap and baking powder or something like that?
Yeah. And now they just make baseball fields. Oh, wait.
Yeah.
No. Here's another one, Eddie. Did you know the reason there's a top 40 for songs is because jukeboxes in the 50s used to only hold 40 songs or records or whatever.
Isn't that ridiculous that we still adhere to that? Yeah. It was just some basic physical limitation that means nothing now.
See, I didn't know that was it. I thought it was like some guy came up with the idea that we would play 40 songs on the radio and rotate them over and over because that's what the human brain could hold as far as like hit music. And so
I thought that Ryan Seacrest couldn't count past 40 when doing his countdown.
Yeah. Yeah. He can barely count forward. Count backwards from 40? No. No, thanks.
Yeah.
Yeah. Here's another one, Eddie. Did you know Tupac's last words were F you? That was when, that's what he said to a cop who was trying to get info about who shot him. Now, the mystery has been, you know, forever. And they didn't they have a court case where they figured out who maybe shot Tupac? Like, they're trying to figure it out. But then that guy died. I can't remember what it is. It's like, it's so complicated to just solve this one, these two.
Did they arrest somebody?
I think they did.
I think that person was released.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, something. But Tupac wasn't going to, you know, he wasn't going to rat them out. So he took it to his grave, unfortunately. Died way too soon.
Gangster till the end.
Yeah, I didn't like when they kept coming out with Tupac music after he died. And I didn't like those holograms they tried to do. That was creepy. Just let it rest. You know, somebody passes away. I think it's just not right. I don't know. I mean, as much as I want, you know, Tupac and Biggie to be alive, it just feels weird when it's like somebody's money grab, you know? Like, they're, and so, yeah, just let them RIP. It's sad, but let them go. It's too bad that they haven't figured out who killed them and that they're gone, but don't do it. Bring a hologram. What's that?
Throw everyone in jail just to be safe.
There you go.
Ask Moonkillers.
Okay, let's spin the wheel and see what category it lands on. You know, people send in a lot of questions they want to have answered, and then I put them in different categories, and then we answer and help people.
Right.
Spinning the wheel, personal development, relationships, financial advice, health and wellness, career and education, lifestyle, and the Mood Killers wheel lands on.
You and your dead wife's ashes, get the hell out of here. Wow, that's a weird category.
That's right. Lifestyle.
Lifestyle, okay.
Yeah. What advice, Mood Killers, do you have for someone looking to travel more?
Well, Eddie, you're a consummate traveler. You've been to France. I think you've been to Italy, haven't you? You've been to... Where
have
you? I have
not been to Italy.
Okay,
I would like to go to Italy.
But
if you want to travel more, I think you have to commit to just doing it. Just do it. And you can't use money as an excuse. You can't use time as an excuse, because if you want to do it, you'll save the money. You'll figure it out. You'll get a sixth job. I don't care. You know, you'll, because there are ways to travel frugally, and you'll still get the same experience as if you were spending more money. I don't spend a lot of money when I travel. I know it's cheaper to travel internationally than it is domestically a lot of times, and people don't realize that. They think, oh no, I'm going to go to London, I'm going to spend $15,000. No, yeah, it's, you might spend more going to Nebraska.
And nobody wants to go to Nebraska.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Do you find, I always think people spend way too much money on a fancy hotel, and then all you literally do is, you know, spend a few minutes in that hotel, sleeping, getting up, taking a shower, and going off and having adventures. So why not just get a decent place to stay that's, you know, relatively close to things? But you don't have to, unless you really are going to spend a lot of time in that hotel, like, you don't really need to, you know, have a, I don't know, like, live like a queen for a few days. You can just go to a regular hotel. It's fine.
Yeah.
And most boutique hotels are pretty affordable in every city. And it's better than, like, just a chain. So you get an experience a little bit. Maybe they've got, like, a cafe or something. And it's nice. Yeah. But you don't have to spend a ton of money at it. That's what I always think. People spend way too much money on accommodations.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Yeah, so those are some good tips, I think. Yeah, there you go. Spin the wheel.
Listen,
lifestyle,
that wheel.
Career and education. Health,
is that
and wellness,
mahogany?
Financial advice.
By the way, is that a mahogany wheel?
Personal development. Yeah. Real mahogany.
Wow. Beautiful.
It's landing on financial advice. Mood killers, what are your top tips for managing debt?
Oh, well, I have found that there are a lot of things, there are a lot of programs, if you're in debt, that you can actually see if you're qualified for, if your debt is, you know, relatively significant. And sometimes you can find programs of, like, maybe like a law firm that is it's a government thing, I think, that has been issued. And a lot of people take part in it. So you can get, like, a law firm behind you that negotiate with banks to help you pay off your debt interest-free. So you're just paying the principal and not the interest. And you can pay it off in a way shorter time than you would if you just paid off debt, you know, with all the interest and everything. So there are a lot of things you can Google and look out for that are available out there that, you know, one small payment a month and you start chipping away at all your debt.
Yeah. Yeah. That's good. Yeah. And tackle those high interest ones first.
And also, yeah, if you have several credit cards and you're just like a simple thing where you're trying to pay off a credit card, take the lowest amount, like say you have like five credit cards and one has like a high amount and one and a couple have lower amounts. Pay minimum payments on the high ones at first, pay off the lower amounts, and then as you go, then start paying off the other ones. So you start out by, you know, and it makes it easier. That way you have a sense of organization about it.
There you go. Susie Orman, you're going out of business.
Ask Mood Killers.
Oh, goody.
We are spinning the wheel. We have certain categories that your questions fall into. So if you want to send in a question, be sure to do that on social media, DM us, or you can email moodkillers@stayanal.com. And we'll answer your question here on the show. And let's spin the wheel. All the categories.
Oh, it's hypnotizing.
Health and wellness. Yes. Financial advice, relationships, personal development, career and education, lifestyle, and it lands on the suspense, health and wellness.
Oh, goody.
Mood killers. How can someone find motivation to exercise regularly?
That's tough.
Well, that is tough.
But once
maybe
you get
you
into
a
routine,
scare,
what?
Go get your yearly physical.
A health scare, that'll do it.
Yeah. That'll do it.
No, once you get into, like, just start with a walk. Even if you're just walking around your block a little bit, it kind of gets you in the mode. Once you kind of get moving, you keep that motion with regularity, and suddenly you realize you don't even think about it anymore. And also, if you find, like, something you enjoy, like, I don't know, people like pickleball, they like basketball, find, like, a game that takes physical activity that's kind of fun, low, you know, low impact or whatever, just have some fun.
Yeah.
And that helps. It's kind of like if you diet, like people always say, like they go to extremes, like no sugar, no this, no that. And they just rip it out of their lives suddenly. But if you do it and you hate the food you're eating, you're not going to stay on that diet. But same with exercise. If you hate everything about it, like I don't like walking on a treadmill inside. I like walking outside when it's, especially when it's nice.
Yeah, I know. Like you're right. Make a game out of it. Play like Sprint and Shriek. You could do that. That's a fun game.
I don't know what that. I don't know what that is. Yeah, I thought you were saying like a game like you know how everything has a step now. Like if you even carry your phone with you, it shows you how many steps you took. Like, see if you can beat your record every day of steps or whatever it is, or timing, or you know something. If you're just walking.
You could also end up in a slasher film. Get some cardio that way.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah, get cast in a slasher film. That's my advice.
Your advice is get in and cast in a slasher film or have a major health scare, and that will get you jolted.
Right. Okay.
Absolutely.
You're welcome. Time to shut the show down.
Yes.
It's over.
Right. Yeah.
But, you know. It's not over for good. It just means it's over for now. And we talked about a lot of things today. It's always fun. I do love it when you bring in that segment where we learn things. And did you know? I think it's one of my favorite. It's a simple thing. And I know that it actually is groundbreaking for people to talk about random facts on the radio. We invented that here.
Right.
And but I really do love this segment, though, because I'd learn. You talked about sriracha. You brought that up and how the rooster on there has a meaning behind it. I didn't realize it did. What was it again? The guy was born during the year of the rooster?
He was born in 1945, the year of the rooster. So that's
so
why.
Then he threw the rooster on the bottle.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, it seems. I just thought it was because, you know, when you get up, it gives you a kick and it makes you go nuts. I
thought that. Yeah, maybe that's what it was too. I always learn something new with that one. I love that.
This is an interesting one. Did you know, Eddie, for 1 hour each year, it's the same time in Oregon and Florida. So parts of eastern Oregon are on mountain time, and parts of Florida, the panhandle, are on central time. So when western Florida sets the clocks back from 2 a.m. to 1 a.m. in the fall, it's also 1 a.m. in eastern Oregon. For like an hour. So that's kind of a like real, you know, like a micro. Did you know? Because like, so what? But it is weird, you know. Like,
it's weird though.
Yeah, it's weird that like part of Oregon.
In that case, the whole mountain time zone then is in essence the same time as. But then I guess they're bringing up Oregon because it's on the west or the Pacific Northwest.
Because it makes, it's the furthest.
The lower east. Yeah.
And here's another one. The original Snow White, the story ends with before they homogenized it for Disney, the story actually ends with the evil queen being forced to put on burning iron shoes and dancing until she drops dead. I would have preferred that, actually. And then, Snow White could have been laughing and cackling with the dwarves standing around. You know, like, look at her. She's going to die in a few minutes. Fun. I don't know. Well, yeah. Fun times.
Yeah. 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 And then we did a tech tickle today where we did some tech news.
Now, and, you brought up Elon Musk a couple of times, and you knew it was going to be triggering.
Triggering. Yeah.
You can't help it.
Well, unfortunately, one of the reasons why we slowed down on the tech tickle is because he dominates tech news. And I just got tired of seeing his stupid name.
Yeah, so, got tired of talking about him. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, literally every story in tech is Elon does this, he does that. And I was like, But here's a positive story we didn't get to that I thought was really cool. I guess for the first time, California has used 100% renewable energy in a month. So between wind, solar, and the other one, I think hydro or something, they for the first time, they're 100% renewable energy in California.
That's great. Now, yeah. My question is, if you are in California, what are electric bills like? Because
soup.
I experience, is there technology that you can use soup to power your, that would be great. Like, hey, you don't want that extra soup? You've got bone broth you can't eat because it's disgusting?
Soup.
Just pour it into this little hole and it'll fuel your entire house for a month. No.
Okay.
I never know. There's no barometer that I can really find that really tells you, like, how do you know what stuff costs? Because 1 month, my bill will seem like I'm fueling a mansion. And then the next month, it's like, okay, yeah, it's normal for where I live. But I don't get it.
Know.
Yeah.
I don't either.
So I hope that renewable energy continues to grow in its popularity and use. And that's great.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, if you missed any of this and you want to catch up, or maybe you want to dig into the archive, all of our Mood Killers shows are available, all like
over
5,000 of them.
No, over 400 episodes we reached this week. Yeah.
Too many.
Yeah, it really is.
Wherever you get your podcasts, we're there, or at moodkillersradio.com.
Mood Killers.
Do not text me during wheel.
Pain in my ankle.